Hi, welcome back to Maker Mindset. This is the second part on a series that is going over the process of building the Ender 3 Pro 3D printer. If you never built a printer before, or if you recently built your printer and you are having problems with it, then this video series is for you. So let's continue. We'll begin with the first step of the assembly of your 3D printer by attaching the 2040 vertical aluminum extrusions. We will go over 12 steps in order to assemble our printer. And at the beginning of each of the steps, we have this little 3D animation that gives us a preview of what we need to accomplish on each step. This is a very important step in building your printer. And I gotta say that if you don't do this right, you're gonna have problems throughout the lifespan of your printer. Here are the two 2040 aluminum extrusions. One of them is responsible for a mild heart attack I had during unboxing, so you should be careful when picking them up. Now, remove the Z-axis screw, which is hidden inside one of them. One of them has screw holes on only one end, while the other one has screw holes on both ends, as you can see here. We're going to need the M545 screws. And for this task, we'll need to pick up the largest hex wrench from the ones that came with the printer. Now you set the base of the printer sideways with the front facing away from you. And you pick up the 2040 aluminum extrusion that only has holes on one end. At this point, you're not supposed to tighten the screws too much. You should still be able to twist or move the aluminum extrusion back and forth. Now let's turn the printer base around and do the other side. And now that I turn the base of the printer around, the printer is facing me. Now for the other 2040 aluminum extrusion, the side where the hole is closer to the end is the one that will be attached to the base of the printer. And as you can see here, one side of those little holes is wider than the other, and the side where the holes are wider should be facing the front of the printer. And here again, you shouldn't tighten the screws too much. Allow the extrusion to be a little loose for now. And here, if you're not very familiar with working with calipers, you may not have noticed that when you move the caliper back and forth, the tail of the caliper also goes in and out. And that little part of the caliper can also be used to do measurements. And that's what we're going to do right now. We should turn the caliper on and zero it if it is not zeroed out. Make sure that it is set to millimeters and not to inches. And you start rolling the caliper until you reach 7 millimeters. Now you turn this little screw here on the top, and that will lock the caliper at its current position. And what we are going to do here is to go under each of the four wheels used to adjust the height of the build plate, and turn them until the screw that is sticking out under them measures exactly 7 millimeters. And we are only doing this because we are going to use the build plate as reference when aligning the 2040 aluminum extrusion at a 90 degree angle. Now, in order to accomplish what we are about to do, I went to Home Depot and made a little investment on my toolbox. I bought those very cute little clamps and a plastic square. Those are not mandatory purchases, but unless you are an octopus, you're gonna have a very hard time accomplishing what we are about to do. So do yourself a favor and spend $17.67 on this whole purchase.
What?
Yes, it was a very good deal. Here you will use the plastic square and one of the little clamps to make sure that the 2040 aluminum extrusion is always at a 90 degree angle. Now you pick up one of the 2020 aluminum extrusions and attach it to the 2040 aluminum extrusion that you're working on. This will help both 2040 aluminum extrusions to remain parallel to each other. Now you pick up the other square that I'm sure you already have in your toolbox and use it to make sure that the aluminum extrusion is always at a 90 degree angle in relation to the build plate. As you remember, the 2040 aluminum extrusion is attached to the base of the printer with two screws. So when you tighten the screw that is closest to you, it will pull the aluminum extrusion towards you. And on the other hand, if you tighten the screw that is farther from you, that will pull the aluminum extrusion away from you. Now, we will have to balance out how much we tighten each of the screws so that at the end of the process, the 2040 aluminum extrusion will be perfectly tight and also at a 90 degree in relation to the build plate. Finally, the 2040 aluminum extrusion is perfectly aligned and both screws are pretty tight. So now, let's do the same on the other side and you already know the drill. First you tighten one screw, then you check to see if the square is perfectly flat with the build plate. If it's not, you tighten the other one, and you keep going back and forth until both screws are tight, and the 2040 aluminum extrusion is at a perfect 90 degree angle in relation to the build plate. Now, remember that you are tightening steel screws into aluminum threads, so you may have to loosen one screw to tighten the other one in order to achieve this perfect alignment without destroying the threads. This step is finally done. Here comes the second step, which is attaching the monitor and the power supply. As you can see on the 3D animation, the installation of the monitor and the power supply are pretty simple, so we are going to go over them very quickly. Actually, we'll start with the power supply. Now, if you live in a country where the voltage on your wall socket is 220 volts, then you should skip this. However, if you live in a country where the voltage is around 115 volts, then you must take this step in order for a printer to work properly. To install the power supply, we are going to need the M420 screws, and we are going to need the second largest hex wrench from the ones that came with the printer. Now you prop up the power supply against the 2040 aluminum extrusion from the left-hand side of the printer and screw away. At this point, you shouldn't be too concerned about tightening the screws too much and destroying the threads because you are tightening steel screws against steel threads. But don't go crazy here. Just tighten the screws well enough so that the power supply is not going to just fall off. Now it's time to install the monitor. We just place it here in front of the left foot of the printer. And we'll need to pick up the M58 screws. And for this, you need again the second largest hex wrench from the ones that came with the printer. There's nothing special about mounting the monitor. But again, you will have to remember that you will be screwing steel screws into aluminum threads. You tighten the screws just well enough so the monitor will stay firm, but don't go crazy tight because you run the risk of destroying the aluminum threads. That's it. Now it's time to attach the Z-stop switch. This step is going to be very short. We just need to screw this little sensor to the 2040 aluminum extrusion of the right-hand side. The ZX switch should be in the same bag as the filament sample that comes with the printer. Here it is. And for this task, you will need the second largest hex wrench from the ones that came with the printer. First, you need to loosen those screws so that the T-nuts will be able to go deep enough inside of the gap and turn sideways. This little plastic notch is going to be at the top of the right foot of the printer. The T-nuts should not give you any headache turning sideways, because you are attaching them to a vertical aluminum extrusion. Done. That's it for now. This video is over, but there will be more next week. Thanks for watching this video all the way to the end. If you want to watch the rest of this series, you can click on this link here on the top, and at the bottom you have a link to a video that the YouTube algorithm thinks will be the best fit for you. So, we'll see you next time.